All right, today I'm going to show you how to save yourself some time when you're running your SSH commands, because there's a lot of things to remember when you're typing out SSH commands, and there's a lot of things that you need to look up often, or maybe you just forget. But we're going to save some time by saving all of that information in a file called SSH config, in the SSH config file. And when we do that, that will save you time every time you have to run an SSH command. You're just going to be able to skip all that stuff, type out a quick little shortcut, and be SSH right to where you need to be. So what are we looking at? Let's look at my instance here. The instance I have running is running at 52.2.238.161. That is an AWS instance. That's the public address of the server. I need to log into this with a public key. I need to remember the username. I need to remember the IP address. Let's assume I don't have any names, any DNS set up for it yet. So let's go ahead and get all of that configured. Normally, if I were to try to connect to this instance, I would need to type SSH dash I with maybe the name of the key that I need to attach. I need EC2 user, which is the name of the user attached to that. And then I'm going to type the IP address. Once I do that, boom, I'm in, I'm logged in. That's fantastic. That's great. The problem is that's a lot of things to have to remember, and you could save it in your history, but it's still a lot of things to have to remember, and there's an easier way. So we're going to go ahead. I'm going to close that connection. I'm going to clear my console so that we can go back. I'm going to pull that command up again. I have ssh-i.ssh/labs user. EC2 user at 52.2.238.161. Remember that command. So now what I'm going to do is open up a little file called SSH config. And that file, I'm going to open it up in VS Code. You can open it up in Vim. You can open it up in Nano, whatever your comfortable place for editing files is. But I'm going to open it up in VS Code because then you've seen it before. I'm going to do code /.ssh/config. The name of that file is important. It has to be .ssh/config. Otherwise, you're going to have to specify where that file is every time. This is the place that SSH automatically looks for its configuration. So let's open that up. All right, so I've got the file open, and if I drag it onto this window so you can see it, you can see it's opened a completely empty file. There's nothing there. What we have to do is add the records that we want to be able to connect with. And how do we do that? We're going to do that with host. We're first going to say host, and then a space, and then I could put in a host of 52.2.238.161. That's the IP address of the thing. So that way, every time I SSH to 52.2.238.161, I could get there. The problem is, that's kind of hard to remember. That's a really hard thing to remember. That's the whole reason DNS exists, is so that we don't have to remember IP addresses. So what are we going to do about it instead? Instead of having host of the IP address, I'm going to say the host is sample. We'll call the host sample. That's just, you can call it whatever you want. Call it something that will help you remember what that server is. In this case, we're just going to call it sample. And now that we've got the host name specified, it's time to tell it what to do when it sees that host name. And the very first thing we're going to do is give it a host name argument. And the host name argument that we're going to put is the IP address. That way, every time that we go to this host of sample, it knows that the host name that we're going to, the destination that we're going to, is that IP address that we have. The next argument that we're going to place is the user. And the user is EC2-user, because that's the username that I use to log in. By default, if you don't specify a user, it's going to use the username of the user that you're currently logged in as. So I'm logged into my computer as Ryan. It's going to try to log into the remote server as Ryan. If there's no Ryan user there, that's not going to work. So that's why we specify here the user command. And now the last thing that I'm going to do, remember the other argument that we had to put into that SSH command, if we scroll back, is ssh-i labs user.pem. I had to specify the key file. So how do we do that? We're going to specify an identity file, and VS Code happily helps me out here, but I'll go ahead and type out the whole thing, identity file, and it has to be exactly like that with the caps, the initial caps for each word. That's important. All is one word, identity file. And the way that we specify the identity file is /.ssh/labsuser.pem. Now, I'm going to save that file, And now .ssh/config is there. So every time I run SSH, it's going to check this file to see if it can find the information that we want. So now I could still type the command exactly as it was before, but instead of that, I am going to start with a new one and just type SSH sample. And guess what? We're in the exact same spot. It took all of the information that we used in that we added in that configuration file and automatically used that to log in. So next time I need to SSH to this server, I can just type SSH sample. If I have more than one server that I want to do, I can pop back open this file, add another host with a different name, and keep going from there and add different configurations and different settings. And there's a lot of other more advanced things that you can do with this configuration file. You can look at the documentation and find more options if there are other things that you want to do. But these are the ones that you need to be able to log in as simply and as easily as possible.